We just learned about configuring SNMP tags using our plugin. Let's now take a quick look at what really is inside the tag configuration. In this chapter, we won't necessarily go into all the details of manually configuring SNMP tags. What we really want you to know is where to find the important pieces of information in their configuration. This could be particularly useful when you want to edit tags after you've imported them in Excel. A good example would be that the IP address of a switch just changed. You could import the hundreds of tags you configured for this switch into Excel. You could then edit the tags and re-export them after they're modified. First of all, the point type. You could use any numerical point type. We normally use float32. For textual values, you could use a string type. And something quite interesting in SNMP is to use digital tags. As SNMP agent reports statuses as numbers, for example, a port on a switch would not be up or down, would simply be 1 or 2. This is what you get out of an SNMP agent. So you normally create digital tags to associate text strings to these numbers. You store them as numbers. But in our client tools, such as process book, you see them as text. Then you have the point source. As usual, this should be the same character as you configured in ICU to identify your interface. $ is the default point source for the SNMP interface. Then the two important attributes are instrument tag and the extended descriptor. They contain keywords. And in some cases, when there are multiple keywords in the same attribute, they are separated by semicolons. Instrument tag contains host equals and then the IP address or the name of the device you want to scan. The extended descriptor contains the password, CS, which stands for community string, equals, and then the password. Remember in ICU, there was a parameter to tell the interface not to read the passwords in the tags configuration. Rather than that, it would read the password in a file. So you could, in some cases, omit this keyword. The most important keyword here is OID. This is the counter to monitor on the device. Normally looks like .1, .3, .6, and so on. Something else you can use in the extended descriptor is the key keyword, which is used to identify the network interface you are monitoring. For example, on a switch, you could have a port called fast ethernet 4/4. So using the keyword, you could tell the interface this tag is meant to monitor this particular port. At some point in time, if the OID you specified here is not associated to the same port on the switch anymore, the tag would not keep collecting data. It would simply tell you configure. You would see this error code in process book, for example, configure. So you know you have to configure it again because it's not valid anymore. Again, like I said a few minutes ago, we won't go into all the details of manually configuring SNMP tags here, as there are a multitude of different parameters you can use. If you do want to configure them manually, we strongly recommend you reading the associated chapter in the SNMP interface documentation. What we normally do is we simply use the plugin. Manual configuration is pretty useful when you want to edit a large number of tags in Excel. So let's keep going with other attributes. The first location code, location 1, is as usual the interface ID number as you configured in ICU. Location 2 and location 3 here are a little bit special in SNMP. Location 2 is the type of OID, the type of variable you want to monitor on your device. Is it a standard counter where the value you get from the SNMP agent is right away sent to PI? Or is this a rate? Bytes in, bytes out, for example, where you have to time normalize the value. A good example of this is given at the bottom of this page. The most popular case in which you use a rate is the number of bytes going in and out of a network interface, a switch port, for example. You have to know that SNMP agent will report the number of bytes in and out as an endlessly increasing number. So if you record raw data out of that, you will get a linear trend. What you have to do when you scan a value, you have to calculate the rate. You get a value, you subtract the previous value, you divide it by the frequency at which you scan, and it gives you the rate. Instead of having a linear trend, you will get a real nice looking trend like this. This is location 2 equals 1. For any other kind of counter, you just leave it to 0. Then location 3 simply determines whether the interface can group the tag or not. Location 3 set to 0 means, well, just leave this tag alone. When you set location 3 to 1, that tells the interface, try to group this tag with other similar tags. Location 2 and location 3 correspond to two options you had in our plugin to configure tags. Let's get back to the plugin. And here we are, the first tab in our SNMP tag configurator. You probably remember this. You have to choose your interface when configured in ICU or manually set the point source, the interface ID number, and the scan class. Take a look at here. Two more options here where you have location 2. When applicable, this plugin will set location 2 to 1 to create rate tags. And here, we tell the plugin to create tags with location 3 equals 1. That means you tell the interface when you can group tags together and make one single call for the group of tags. And here we have an option to omit the community string in the extended descriptor. That means you don't put the CS equal. You don't write the community string, you don't write the password into the tag configuration. That assumes you used the option in ICU to tell the interface to read the passwords from a file. Then the two last location codes, location 4 is as usual the number of the scan class you want to use as configured in ICU, and location 5 the debugging level, normally set to 0. The interface will not write anything to the pypc.log file. If you're not getting the expected result out of a tag, you could set location 5 to 1, 2, or 3 to get more or less messages written to the log file. And the last attribute I'd like to talk about is converse, which is a simple number to multiply the value you got from the agent before to archive it into PI. A good example of that would be to convert bytes into kilobytes or megabytes.